Christ also suffered for sins once for all, the righteous for the unrighteous, in order to bring you to God. He was put to death in the flesh, but made alive in the Spirit, in which also he went and made a proclamation to the spirits in prison, who in former times did not obey, when God waited patiently in the days of Noah, during the building of the ark, in which a few, that is, eight persons, were saved through water. And baptism, which this prefigured, now saves you, not as a removal of dirt from the body, but as an appeal to God for a good conscience, through the resurrection of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God, with angels, authorities, and powers made subject to him. Oh, praise the one who would reach for me.
Scripture today, Peter highlights God's patience. God waited patiently in Noah's days when the proclamation that a flood was coming went out. Only eight people were saved alive as the ark went through the floodwaters, as an early type of baptism. Peter connects the account of Noah being saved through the waters with the waters of baptism. Following Jesus in baptism appeals to God for a clean conscience. We are buried with Christ in baptism and raised again to newness of life. We can have a good conscience through a right relationship with God. We have been reconciled to God through the incarnation, the suffering, and the resurrection of Christ. God is still patient. Ever since Jesus Christ suffered once and for all for the salvation of the world, God has continued to be patient, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to salvation. God, through Jesus, provided proclamation and demonstration for those who needed to hear good news. Now, God calls us to share the good news of Jesus with the gifts and graces God has given us everywhere we go. Jesus, who was put to death in the flesh and made alive in the Spirit, has gone before us, ascended to heaven, and rules and reigns from his seat at the right hand of God, above angels, authorities, and powers. While we have life and breath, let's continue to share this good news about Jesus. A distant and removed, but you chased us down in merciful pursuit.
To the sinner, you most loving grace, Father, whose will it is for us to give thanks for all things, to fear nothing but the loss of you, and to cast all our care on you who cares for us. Preserve me from faithless fears and worldly anxieties, that no clouds of this mortal life may hide from me the light of that love which is immortal, and which you have manifested to us in your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, for by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.